joined by Hofstra head coach Joe Mihalik, following the team's 69-67 loss in overtime to VCU. Coach, just so your thoughts on what was really a thrilling basketball game for your program.
It was an incredible game. I mean, to come in here, these people, they really got it going on here. This is kind of college basketball at its finest right here. The environment, the atmosphere, you know, they never played on an empty seat. Every place is packed, the band is going, the fans are into every play. And our guys were the toughest team on the floor. And it's just heartbreaking. It's just heartbreaking to be so close. And, you know, I'm so proud of our guys. I mean, we had a chance to pack it in. You know, we let a feel-good team feel good. At the end of the second half, they threw a banked one in from 30 feet. They're up 13. We could have packed it in. Next thing you know, there's 10 minutes to go in the half in the game, and we're up. I'm so proud of our guys. We had our chances. Just one play here, one play there. You know, you pick it out. Anybody here could do that. Maybe a rebound we could have got there. Maybe a shot we could have made here. Maybe one less turnover here or there, you know. But so proud of our guys.
Coach, you talked about the 13-point halftime deficit that you guys fought back from. What did you kind of say to your team at halftime? It allowed your team to just battle back and eventually take the lead there.
We just talked about the old. You can't go out there and make a shot and have a 13-point shot. You know, a little bit of the attrition has to set in one play at a time. And we even said, let's get to the first media timeout and be down 9 or 8. And we did. We were down 8. But you know what? It was 6 with the ball. And I think one of our guys turned the ball over. So that made it 8. Could have been 6, but it wasn't. And there could have been one of those one plays. But hey, listen, we're not gonna be able to sleep tonight. For the rest of the year, we'll think about what a great win this could have been. But we'll also know that a game like this could be the reason we can in March be one of the teams that can win a championship.
Coach, you got some great offense performances as usual from your trio. But you got a real strong rebounding effort from Jaquiel Taylor. Can you talk about what you thought about his efforts?
Yeah, Jaquiel, 17 rebounds. I mean, that's a heck of a lot of rebounds. I mean, he went after the ball, you know, got some, as you said, they were tough rebounds. I mean, there wasn't an easy play out there tonight. Nobody got an easy shot. Nobody got anything easy. So, yeah, happy for Jaquiel. Really happy that Jalen Ray came to life. You know, he's a terrific player, Jalen Ray. And he had a little bit of a hamstring injury in the preseason. He wasn't quite himself, but tonight, he's back, and that gives us some more firepower.
Coach, Justin Wright-Foreman going into halftime, 4 points, not a great shooting percentage, but comes back and really proves that he is the leader of this team, drops 23 in that second half. I mean, you can't say enough about the team overall, but Justin, just talk about how he was able to overcome adversity in that second half, because they were doubling every time he touched the ball.
You know what? We've been talking since July about all the things teams will do to Justin. Trap him on ball screens, overplay him, force him to his right, not let him use ball screens. You know, and he answered the bell. I mean, they did a good job with him in the first half. You know, needless to say, he kept his poise. He could have been frustrated. At times he did get frustrated. But to still be able to have the confidence that he has, the toughness that he has, to want the ball and defy the logic of the great defense that VCU threw at him and get 23 points, that just shows what a great player he is.
VCU, not a great three-point shooting team, but they had a ton of success, 6 for 17 in the first half, but they came out, didn't make a three in the entire second half. What was your mindset as the coach heading into that next half? Were you thinking, we have to pressure them, or is it, I know they're not going to be able to come out with that kind of strength and be on the arc, but we have to focus on rebounding?
We just made a slight couple of changes with some of our coverages, and it worked out. Sometimes it does, sometimes it doesn't. It worked out, and our guys were great. Our guys did a better job with their closeouts. They did a better job of reading ball screens. They did a better job of pressuring the ball and making them uncomfortable. And I mean, again, a team that like a feel good team. I don't mean that as a knock. But they're a team that when they're feeling good, it's really, really good. And in the second half, they scored 25 points. I mean, that's a real credit to our defense.
Coach, last question. Just talk about the advantage a game like this gives your team heading into CAA play. I know it's not coming up immediately, but when it does, talk about the advantage this gives you.
Well, you know, you play games like this to get yourself ready for league play. And you're probably tired of hearing me say that. I apologize. But, you know, the question keeps getting asked about playing tough games, and it's the only really good answer I have. I mean, you know, we see a defense like this. We play in an environment. We won't see this. Wilmington's the closest thing we'll see to this. And so maybe it gets us ready for Wilmington. It gets us ready for Charleston. And, you know, so, but, you know, games like this, it's why you play them.